GaN charger is the most frequently mentioned word in our channel. We've taken apart many GaN chargers. However, many people may not know what GaN is. Let us talk about it today. GaN is the abbreviation of gallium nitride. It's a compound of nitrogen and gallium and is well known as a third generation semiconductor material. The structure is similar to wurtzite with high hardness. It also has a very wide band gap of 3.4 electron volts and can be used in high power, high speed optoelectronic components. If you look at it from the outside, you will find that it's generally like yellow powder. It can produce chemical reactions when exposed to water and is non-flammable. The compound was first synthesized in 1928. After 70 years of continuous development, it was widely used in diodes in the 1990s. The performance of GaN switch transistors is much better than that of silicon-based switch transistors, which is mainly reflected in the following 5 aspects: higher breakdown voltage, faster switching frequency, lower on resistance, higher thermal conductivity, lower switching losses. Furthermore, it can be grown on a variety of substrate, including sapphire, silicon carbide, and silicon. So it can achieve higher efficiency, higher power density, or even both after replacing silicon components with GaN components. For now, GaN components are widely used in many fields. For example, GaN semiconductors can be used in military electronics industry. It's now the first choice for producing large-scale surge radars for fighter aircraft. And it can also be used in base stations. The higher energy efficiency, wider bandwidths, higher power density, and smaller size make it ideal for next-generation base stations, especially in the frequency band above 1.8 GHz. In the field of optoelectronics, GaN is used to make LEDs and lasers. GaN can be mixed with indium or aluminum to create LEDs with color ranging from red to ultraviolet, and the GaN-based violet laser diodes are used to read Blu-ray discs. But in ChargerLAB, what we most concerned about is how it is used in chargers. It's not very long for GaN components to be used in chargers. Back in 2014, Navitas was just founded, launched the world's first GaN power IC prototype. In 2018, it was first adopted by Anker in their chargers. Then more and more manufacturers began to do so, and even Apple launched its first 140 watts GaN charger. So how does GaN allow chargers to significantly reduce size and increase output power? First, we need to understand how the charger works. In most cases, the transformer is the largest component in the charger. When the output power is fixed, its size is directly related to the frequency of the pulsed current, that's F. When the voltage U remains unchanged, if we want to reduce the size, that is reduce the cross-section area, S, the best way is to increase the frequency, F. And switch transistor can control the frequency. In the process of continuous switching, the GaN switch transistor can reach higher frequencies than the silicon transistor. The loss is lower and the heat dissipation efficiency is higher, so the charger and transformer can be smaller than before. The charger is just a device that can convert high voltage AC into low voltage DC. Switching transistors are the most common components in chargers. When used with capacitors and inductors, they can be used in rectifier circuits, box circuits, and PFC circuits. The primary MOSFET and PFC MOSFET are gradually being replaced by GaN components. Some chargers also adopt GaN components to replace synchronous rectification MOSFET, like the Anker GaN Prime series. The synchronous buck MOSFET and V-bus MOSFET may also be gradually replaced by GaN components in the future. Since it can reduce size, weight, and cost, GaN components will become a popular material for producing charger switch transistors. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please click the corners to check more explained videos made by ChargerLAB. And don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye!